Let's take the basics of learning how to copy and paste information, as well as cutting and pasting information. To do this, you'll be using the Windows Clipboard. For most of us, the Windows Clipboard is really an imaginary place that we don't often see. However, when you're using Office, the Windows Clipboard will hold up to 24 different objects in it, and you actually can ask for that clipboard to be displayed. In the Home tab, you'll find the very first group listed is the clipboard group. And now you know that in the lower right-hand corner, if you see the Dialog launcher, that little curved arrow, and click on it, it will launch the Dialog box. In this case, it launches the Windows clipboard. And at this point, it tells me the clipboard is empty. Now, just a simple copy and paste or cut and paste, I don't typically use the clipboard. However, I want to get a little bit fancier in this demonstration so that as you work with it, you'll know how to use that clipboard also. In this example, we are going to begin with cutting and pasting information. As you look at the document that I have here, you can see that the paragraphs are all out of order, including the title. So what I want to do is rearrange all these paragraphs into the correct order using the Windows Clipboard. We're going to cut them out of the original location and paste them into the new location. So the first thing I'm going to do is one by one cut these paragraphs out. I will need to be using the Home tab and looking in the clipboard group for those. Notice that you have cut, copy, and paste listed here. Right now they're grayed out, which means they're not active, and the only reason for that is I don't have something selected. As soon as I select something, then I will have the ability to cut, copy, that information. So I'm going to use my good selecting skills, move out to the selection area to the left hand side, and a good double click will select that paragraph. I am going to, this first time, use the buttons that are available to me in the toolbar, and I'm going to cut. Notice as soon as I did that, it appears in the clipboard below. I'm going to do the same thing with the next paragraph. I don't really care the order that I do this in. I'm simply selecting the paragraphs, cutting them, and it continues to add those to that Windows clipboard. When I do the next paragraph, rather than using the buttons in the toolbar, I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut to do that. The keyboard shortcut for cutting is Control plus X. Using a keyboard shortcut, you would press and hold Control and quickly tap and release the X key. Now, if you forgot what the keyboard shortcut was, it's an easy way to look is just to simply use the mouse holding still on the button in the ribbon, and notice that the hint will tell you that the keyboard shortcut for cut is actually Control X. So if you forget, don't worry, you can always use that as a quick hint to help you. Control X on the keyboard, same thing, it instantly takes that and places it on the Windows clipboard. So all I have to do is select, cut, select, cut. Any method that I like for doing that, I can. Now, all of my document, or all the paragraphs, including the title, are listed in the Windows clipboard. All I have to do now, and in fact, I could open an entirely different document. I could go to any Office application and have this same clipboard available to me. I'm going to remain in here, and I'm simply going to choose from this clipboard the things that I want. I can click on them, and as soon as I click on it, notice it instantly placed it in my document. Or if I pause on top of it, there is a triangle that points down, which tells me I'll get a list of choices, and from that list I can also choose paste to place that in there, and I'm going to continue pasting my document, and now I have it in correct order. So you can see the Windows clipboard is very easy to use. In addition, whether or not you use the clipboard, every time you paste, you're going to, at the end of what you have pasted, see the paste options dialog box. And all that's telling you is that there are other options for how you could paste this information. I can simply ignore it, or if I want to see what those options are, click on it and look at the options that are listed there. Depending on what I'm doing, I might see different options. Keep source formatting, I could match my destination if I was pasting into another document that had different formatting. Keep the text only, no formatting. And right now it's just the I could set up how I want to customize and have it always by default automatically paste that information in. Keep source formatting was fine with me, so I'm going to just select that. Typically, if I like how it did it, I'll just ignore that paste options and it will disappear in just a couple seconds.